Testing 1, 2, 3, 4.
Monsters do have their place in the zoo, in your nightmares, in the deep, in your favorite horror movies, but not in your living room.
I want to talk about cable. Now, the other day, when I was talking about the cat that goes poop out there, or was that just this morning? I forget. I need another potion. Yes. Here we go. Yeah. It's just wine I'm trying to cut down. Yeah, but I still... He doesn't need the potions, but he drinks them anyway. Oh, I'm sorry. To your health, too. Last night, the cat crapped out there, out the window.
Crapped out there, out the window out there.
Yeah, you know, out there.
And,
I was remembering how the day before that, on the other day,
a salesman came to the door to try to sell me AT&T bundled for your telephone, for your television, for your internet, and I was like, no, thank you, trying to be polite. And my neighbor came by and started yelling and screaming. Well, he started off moderately. If you come and insult my wife again at my door, I will...
What will you do, Daddy?
I will...
What will you do, Daddy?
Smother that girl in chocolate syrup and boogie till the cows come home.
If she were my daughter, I'd...
What would you do, Daddy?
If she were my daughter, I'd...
What would you do, Daddy?
If she were my daughter, I'd...
What would you do, Daddy?
Smother my daughter in chocolate syrup. Strap her on again, oh baby.
So, after he ended up yelling at the salesman, and the salesman yelled at him, and they went back and forth, and finally the salesman ran away. Thank God. I had to go out to witness this to remind them that someone's looking, so don't start a fight here. And then I told my neighbor that I wanted to film his cat crapping in my yard, and then his dog coming in and eating the cat's crap. What's that up here? What's this? I've got a spot up there. What is that? I'll drown it.
Yes. To your health. To both of you. Yes. So...
But not in your living room. On your TV. Don't let pay TV be the monster in your living room.
I remember we have this cable company here called Cox Cable, and they bought out 10 or 20 years ago, they bought out Mission Cable. Now, Mission Cable had grown out of one of the first cable systems in the nation.
Yay! I lived where the first cable went in. Ooh, yes.
I'm going to zoom back a little bit, if you don't mind. There we go. Yeah. Cox from Mission, from whatever they, I forget what they called the cable. We just called it the cable. And I remember back in the 60s, they built this thing, cable. And they could get Los Angeles television stations. You hear that? Los Angeles. Los Angeles. Yes. They could get Los Angeles television. Channel 11. Channel 9. Channel 13. Channel 7. Channel 5. Oh my God, there were good cartoons on Channel 5. I died for those LA channels and we couldn't get any of them.
LA Television, Los Angeles.
Channel 5. I died for those LA channels, and we couldn't get any of them. Because we were down in the canyon, down there. We couldn't get any of them. We were down in the canyon. We could hardly get the San Diego channels. They were all double images and ghosts and all that stuff. Because the signals bounced off the mountains and got all scrambled up. And we had a little portable TV with rabbit ears. That's all we had because we couldn't get a good signal. My parents thought, well, it's not worth spending the money. We had enough to get by, but we didn't have enough to drop hundreds of dollars on a color TV. Oh, no. We didn't have that much, no. But we had enough to eat, so I was happy. Except we didn't have a color TV. But anyhow, cable came, and I wanted cable so bad, because then we could get a color TV, and then we could watch Ed Sullivan in color, but we didn't, because the movie companies filed suit against the cable companies, and they got their hands were tied. My hands are tied. I can't do it.
Pay TV and cable TV companies are seeking the right to charge you for the very programs you now get free. If you want to stop pay TV and save free television, sign the petition in the lobby of this theater. Let your lawmakers know how you feel in the fight against pay TV and cable TV.
Yeah, so we didn't get cable until the Supreme Court resolved the issue. 10 freaking years later, and of course by then I'd already moved out. I wasn't actually married, but I did have a woman I lived with, and we were both working, and she got pregnant, and so I definitely wasn't living at home anymore. Nope. We came back to visit, and the parents had cable. My parents had cable. The Supreme Court had resolved the suit, and the parents had cable. And they always had cable ever since then. So anyway, this guy came from AT&T the other day to try to talk us in. I said, we have an AT&T phone. Oh, that's good. He said, that's good. You need AT&T internet and you need AT&T for your cable. Not cable, you need AT&T for your TV. And I was like, I don't buy things from door-to-door salesmen. Never. The men come around selling meat. I'm in your neighborhood selling meat to your neighbors. You want some? No. I want to go to the store and poke a meat and look at it and feel it. I don't want you just bringing me a box and saying, here, take it, it's yours. Now pay me. No. So I never buy anything from the door. Never. I always investigate and study and do my research. I bought all the Christmas presents for the brothers and sisters and the nephews and the nieces all online after studying and studying and looking at this and looking at that and deciding, okay, my sister-in-law loves Alfred Bierstadt, so I'll buy her this little book of Alfred Bierstadt. And my brother-in-law loves Jesus, so I got him a mouse pad.
Says, blessed is the Lord. Well, where was I? Oh yes, I was talking about cable. So, that's all I wanted to say was AT&T came by and my neighbor yelled at him and I remembered cable and
I'll edit these two videos together with a beautiful old advertisement I found from the movie ads about, I watched it in the movie theaters and I was so pissed because I knew it meant that I wouldn't get cable. They were gonna freaking sue. And you know, a good book says, settle your disputes. On the way to the temple, if you run into the man that's upset you, work it out with him. Yes. So, that's all I have to say. Goodbye. And goodbye to you too.